Very good morning to all the students of class plus 2C. So we are going to finish this poem today. We are going to conclude the concept of this poem today only. So we have read three stanzas. In the very first stanza, poet Stephen Spender. Yes, beta, you were absent. That's why I'm going to repeat, because you did not attend, neither you have attended online or offline, so that's why. Kindly pay attention here. So in the very first stanza, Stephen Spender, he has discussed the various children sitting in the classroom. So elementary school, which is situated in a slum area, fine, where poor people live, people hailing from poor background. And in the very first stanza, he will be discussing that what sort of children are sitting. One tall girl with weighed down head, another paper-seeming boy, very thin boy. They're not getting proper food, basic amenities of life. Fine, hunger could be seen in their eyes. So in first stanza, various children are categorized that what sort of children are sitting, hailing from poor background. Clear? Now, talking about the second stanza, poet is telling us about the condition of classroom in elementary school in slum. Clear? Walls are very dull, as if they're not painted properly. The color of the walls is dull, pale, creamish color, sour cream walls, they have said. And on the walls, donated things are pasted, like portrait of Shakespeare, one open-handed map, then picture of Tarlis Valley, fine, big structures and domes, then scenery of that dawn period, early morning period. So all these pictures are in direct contrast with the lives of these children. Fine, they do not know who Shakespeare is. They have never visited such beautiful valley or natural surroundings like Tarlis Valley. They do not know where they will be visiting. The world map is there in front of them, but they don't know where their world is leading. Clear? So that's why poet is stressing on the donations, because these things donated by people are in contrast with the lives of these children. Clear? Then in third stanza, poet has, you know, concentrated again on the poverty of these children. One child is wearing mended glass, like bottle bits on stones. Means a lot of scratches are there on his spectacles, but he does not have money enough to repair it or buy new glasses. Then he has talked about that the skin or the body of these children, it is like a slag heap, like a garbage dump, you can say. Bones are peeping out of the skin. One can see that bones are quite visible from the skin. They are so thin because they're not getting proper food. And for such children, when you are bitter, when you are hungry, when you are not getting proper sleep, when basic amenities, you are not having proper clothing, how you can expect of having higher level of achievements, that I will become this or I will become that? Firstly, person think of fulfilling his stomach only. So poet here is saying that these children who are devoid of basic amenities of life, how can we expect them that they would be liking and admiring the pasted things on the wall? Surely for such children, Shakespeare is wicked, evil. They do not know who Shakespeare is. They do not know about world map. They do not understand where Tarlis Valley is situated. Fine, because they have never ever access to these things in life. Fine. So after telling about the children and donated things and condition of the wall, do you find positivity in three stanzas or negativity? Negativity. Optimism or pessimism? Pessimism. Pessimism means negativity only. Clear? Keep on enhancing your vocabulary. And in class plus two, rather than using negativity, you can say pessimism. Clear? Terminology should be clear. The more good words you will be using, the more marks you will be attaining accordingly. Clear? So in the last stanza now, as you can see, I have written, try to understand. The last stanza is optimistic enough, showing hope. in which Stephen Spender is hoping something for the betterment of these children. He's wishing, fine, that people in power would come out and help these needy people. Clear? So I have written two words, catacombs and azure. Azure means clear. They have used the word azure sky, run azure on gold sands, fine, which is visible, which is clear. Catacombs are cemeteries. This word earlier was used for cemeteries. When a person dies, cemeteries are there, tombs are generated, walls are created. Fine. Catacombs are confined boundaries, actually. Fine. This question was there in boards and children were not able to understand because they do not pay attention to words only. If your vocabulary is poor, you won't be able to understand the statement even then. Clear? So work upon your vocabulary. So confined boundaries, you can say. So here poet is saying that what sort of life these children are leading? They are bound in confined life only. They have do not access to natural surroundings or outer world. Clear? Now, in the last stanza, let's continue. Unless governor, inspector, visitor. Now, in this line, poet Stephen Spender says, unless and until these people in power, underline all these people, they are government officials, they are political leaders, they are inspectors, visitors, fine. Any strata of the society which can do something to uplift the level of these people, slum children. So he's saying this map becomes their window and these windows that shut upon their lives like catacombs. Now try to understand important line beta it is. He's saying that the map which is mounted on the wall, pasted on the wall, only that map is, you can say, from where they can have look of the outer world. Practically, they are leading nowhere. Fine. This map becomes their window. Fine. This is the window. What is the purpose of a window in a room? You can peep out. You can look what is happening outside. Fine. So this map is a window. It is playing the role of a window for them. Window to see the outer world. Clear? So through the map only, these children can have a glance that where different states and cities are situated. That's it. They cannot think beyond it. They cannot think that let's move to another place because they're very poverty-stricken people. So these windows, now the windows of the classroom, shut upon their lives like catacombs. So that they are in the confined walls of the classroom only. They cannot think beyond it. And actually, catacomb here means boundary of the slum area. Clear? They are residing in slum area. They will be living in slum area. They have been living in slum area. There is no change because nobody is coming forward to help them. There is no chance of their upliftment or change or reformation. Clear? So that's why they are saying that these windows are like shutting their lives like catacombs only. They cannot come outside the catacomb. Break, oh break, open till they break the town and show the children to green fields and make their world run azure on gold sands. So poet here is trying to say, he is actually making a request to all the authorities that dear authority, kindly do something for the sake of these slum children. So it is a way of asking for help or hoping for their upliftment. Clear? So he's saying, let's break those shackles. Let's break that catacomb which is surrounding them. Let them have new opportunities in life. He's saying, show the children to green fields. Green fields here means let them learn or let them gain knowledge into natural surroundings. Fine? Green here, underline the word green. It is a metaphor here, beta. Metaphor means when direct comparison is made. Clear? Simile is when we use as or like. So in this, green is a metaphor. Underline the word green. And another word is white. Underline the word white also. It is also a metaphor. It is used for books. White here means books. Green here means natural surroundings. Fine. So poet Stephen Spender is saying that let these children reach the natural surroundings and enhance their knowledge. Let these children study harder and gain quality knowledge. Fine. And make their world run azure on gold sands. Now, what do you mean by gold sands? Where sun's reflection falls on the sand. Clear? When sun's reflection falls on the sand, it looks like gold only. So poet is saying, let them relish, let them enjoy the beautiful natural surroundings. If they will be remaining in the catacombs, in confined boundaries, they cannot achieve heights of success. You have to fly away. You have to spread your wings. Why many children are moving to abroad? Your parents, they like sending you abroad. No, they are very afraid. In heart of heart, they are scared. If my child, my girl and my boy, they are going, what will happen? How they will adjust? But even then they send, you know, most of the children are going to foreign countries. Why? Because they want you to be successful in lives. Successful doesn't mean you will be going abroad, you will be successful, or they will be, many of you will be going to metro cities even. Sometimes you get very good job in multinational company in Delhi, Gurgaon and Bombay. Your parents, they let you go. In heart of hearts, they don't want to. But their brain says, yes, my child is growing. If I will keep that child in the surroundings, in the nearby, in the home only, that person cannot grow. You have to take risks in life if you want to achieve something. Fine? So similarly, he's saying that if we keep on making these children in slum area only, they won't grow in life. Their lives will be shut only. So let them have more opportunities. Let them go outside beyond boundaries. Let them explore the outer world. Clear? So make their world run azure on gold sands. Let them relish natural surroundings. Let their, underline this beautiful line, one of my favorites, let their tongues run naked into books. Naked into books. What does it mean? Means let them have quality education. This line means let them have quality education. Let their tongues run naked into books. Means books are there. One should have knowledge by experience. Let them experience the things. And let them gain quality education. If Shakespeare's portrait is being hung, let them know who Shakespeare is. Let them read the literature of Shakespeare. If world map is being hung, let them visit various places of the world. Fine? If Tarlis Valley is there or early morning period is depicted, let them rise in life the way picture is depicting. Fine? So he's trying to say, let their tongues run naked into books means let them have quality education. Let them have fluency of language. Okay, why parents send their children to public schools? Because they know the quality will be not, they won't compromise with the quality in that way. Fine, so quality education, where it comes to quality education, everyone wants their children to get the best out of it. Fine. Now, and the white and green leaves open. White means books. Green means natural surroundings. I already told you. So white and green are metaphors here. Okay. Open history They are saying, let them open the books, let them open the green world, let them relish it. At the end, this is the crux of the whole poem. What will happen if we will do everything, if we will provide them quality education, if we will provide them opportunities to visit the world, if we will not make their lives confined, what will happen? So poet is saying, history is theirs whose language is the sun. Means only those people can create history, those who have experienced all these things. Fine. If you want to achieve something, you have to gain something first. Clear the last line. Okay, students, send me thumbs up. History can be created by the ones who have experienced quality education, who have not lived life in confined boundaries, who have been attaining heights by exploring the outer world and grabbing all the opportunities. Jaldi se send me thumbs up. Let me see those who are there. Sukhmanjot, Vaibhav, Suhani, Vanshika, Lakshet, Rana Gurji, Takshi, Kanubha. Those who are not sending thumbs up, they are absent for me, and they are, let me announce the names. Hansika has not sent me thumbs up. Anushka has sent. Gaurav has sent immediately. I was about to take your name, Gaurav, only. Divyaleen, where are you? You have not sent me any thumbs up. Divyaleen. Rest of the students. Kapil. So two students, Kapil Luther and Divyaleen, they are not there. Okay, this is my way of checking. So you are absent for me today. Then they say, ma'am, I was present. Physically, you're not sitting there. Rest, all the students have sent me thumbs up. So, beta, any doubt to any one of you about any word or any expression? All clear? These children also, beta, if it is clear, let me tell you, there are two poetic devices used in this stanza. Let's continue with that. Now, first one is metaphor. I already told you, white and green. What is a metaphor? Yes, last boy, please tell me. Kya hota hai metaphor? Book chahiye nahi hai. There is nothing written about this. What is a metaphor? Poetic device hai. That's it. Yes. It is used to make direct comparison. If I say, Dipin, you are like a lion. You are so brave. Fine? Like a lion. It means it's a simile. If I say, Dipin is as brave as a lion. Again, it is a simile. If I say, you are a lion for me. Means directly I'm calling him a lion. It means metaphor. In very simple language, I am making you understand. Okay, Anshul, Vansh, Ansh, fine. So you should understand in a very simple language, I am telling you. Clear? Direct comparison, metaphor, as or like, simile. Fine? Now, next thing is, you might not have even heard about it. Let me adjust. Next poetic device is, anaphora. ये आपको नहीं आता होगा. Anaphora. It's A. Clear? A-N-A-P-H-O-R-A. Now, anaphora, it is a poetic device when two words are repeated in consecutive lines. Fine, don't take it as repetition. Repetition device is another. Clear? Anaphora is when टू वर्ड्स आर रिपीटेड इन कंसेक्यूटिव लाइंस. आप देखो लास्ट थर्ड लाइन रन इज योर ऑन गोल्ड सैंड्स, देन लास्ट सेकंड लाइन रन नेकेड इनटू बुक्स. टू कंसेक्यूटिव लाइंस आर देयर एंड वर्ड इज रिपीटेड, दैट इज द डिवाइस ऑफ एनाफोरा. क्लियर? सो इन द लास्ट स्टांजा वी हैव मेटाफोर एंड एनाफोरा. क्लियर? टू वर्ड्स बेटा आर रिपीटेड इन कंसेक्यूटिव लाइंस. क्लियर? So these are the poetic devices we have done side by side. If you want to ask any question, you can ask me. All set, all clear. What are the themes of this poem? Number one, social inequality and injustice. Fine. Number two, condition of slum children. On the very first day I taught this. Remember? But you should have revision also, quick revision. Social inequality or injustice, condition of slum children, that, yes, lack of quality education, or you can say education system. The next is political system of our country. And last one is lack of opportunities for all. That is social injustice also. But in, you can make another point. Fine. Now let's do the question answers. Page 93. Choose one answer. Jaldi se aap karo. Think it out. Tick the item which best answers the following. The tall girl. This is the kind of questions you will be getting in boards. Fine. The tall girl with her weighed down head means she is ill and exhausted. She has her head bent with shame. She has untidy hair. Yes, what is the answer? Ill and exhausted. Fine. So she is already not feeling well. Weight of responsibilities, because she's not feeling good. She's exhausted from her life. So first is the answer. Very good. Your name is? Rasika. Fine. So Rasika has given correct answer. Second, the paper seeming boy with rat's eyes means. Now, the children here, raise your hand and give answer to this question, beta. Jaldi say, the paper seeming boy with rat's eyes means. Suhani has given, that boy is thin, hungry and weak. Correct answer, Suhani. Others also, beta, be quick in while giving answers. Third is, the stunted, unlucky year of twisted bones means. Yes, Chandan. Yes, correct answer Chandan has given. It means the boy has an inherited disability. His eyes live in a dream. Yes. Sukmanjot, correct answer, beta. His eyes live in a dream, a squirrel's game in the tree room. Other than this means the boy is, you are saying full of hope. One is saying distracted from the lesson. Mentally, nobody is saying. Yes, what do you say? Distracted from the lesson. Rasika, what do you think? Distracted. Yes, Rishti. Distracted. These children, those sitting at home, tell me the answer. Beta, they have clearly mentioned that his lives live in a dream. So this line depicts that he's full of hope. He's the only one who's not sitting weighed down head, who's not, you know, feeling bad. He's different from others. Maybe he's having different aspirations. He wants to achieve something and he's happy in his life. Clear? So he's full of hope in the future. This is the correct answer. The children's faces are compared to. But a trick is there to attempt objective questions. What you will be doing, there will be four options always, not two and three. Always four options will be there. So there are directly one answer is there which does not stand anywhere. That you just discard. You put a small cross on it. दिस थिंग आई एम नॉट गोइंग टू इवन लुक एट, कि ये नहीं है, देन देर विल बी 50% चांसेस, लाइक 50% चांसेस देर अमंगेस्ट दीज थ्रीज, फाइन. And you know the way people play कौन बनेगा करोड़पति, sometimes you have to read thoroughly the chapters, because any information can become a question. It doesn't mean you will be doing ratification now. You have to have proper knowledge. But while doing objective, firstly cut off the options which do not stand anywhere, and then there will be always a great confusion between the two. But that will be in few questions only. Like suppose you got 10 questions of literature as objective ones. Fine. 5 and 6 clearly you have attempted. There will be 3 to 4 questions, because your paper is marked. When they make a paper, there is clearly mentioned 25 to 30% paper is for top scorers, where you have to apply your brain ki how to answer it. And 25 to 30% paper will be like that. That is for low scorers, the students who are not intelligent enough, and easily everybody will be able to do it. 50% paper, that is for mediocres, you can say. Fine. Sometimes you have to. And how you can score better than others? By having good vocabulary, by having good presence of mind and concentration level. At that time, if you are asking others, sometimes you know the correct answer, you do not believe yourself. You ask your friends, okay, what is the answer? In that case, you also, you ruin your marks. Fine. So you have to gain knowledge. So Bella has gone. Can't continue. We are done with this. Next Monday, we would be doing stanza-wise questions and further writing skills and all. Have a nice day, Bella.